You need a resume when looking for a data science job, but it's often not enough. You need something else to help you to stand out among other candidates, which is a portfolio. A portfolio is a public showcase or gallery that demonstrates what you can do with data science and how good you can do it. So now, let's take a look at the four criteria of a killer portfolio that will help you to get a data science job. Number one, use real-world datasets. Now, anybody can build a data science project just by watching some YouTube videos or taking some online courses. But these projects that they build is normally using what I call the toy datasets, like the Titanic datasets or the Iris Flower dataset. Now, don't get me wrong, these are datasets suitable for learning data science, but they do not solve a business problem directly. So the interviewers might not be able to link it with their business. So what you should do instead is to use datasets that solve an actual business problem. You can find these datasets from Kaggle.com. There are hundreds of real-world datasets used in different industries like oil and gas, real estate, insurance, etc. And you can download them and use them in your portfolio projects for free. Number two, make sure the projects are relevant. Be strategic when presenting your work. Do not simply list down your projects without any thoughts. Only list down projects that are relevant to the industry you're applying to. If you're applying for a data scientist job in an e-commerce company, you want to showcase projects with different business problems, from product recommendations, customer profiling, to sales forecasting. Now, if you're looking for a data scientist job in a property agency like iProperty, Property Guru, and they expect to see projects like property price prediction, residential cluster analysis, and maybe crime prediction dashboards around the residential areas. Number three, showcase different techniques. On top of showing projects that are related to your industry, you should also demonstrate a variety of skills in your portfolio. Now, how do you do that? By using a different set of techniques. For example, if you're working on projects related to F&B industry, you might want to showcase how to use regressions to predict the ROI when you advertise on social media, or how to analyze public sentiments of your restaurants in Google reviews and Facebook comments. You can also showcase how to analyze customers' orders so that you can find the best-selling item on your menu and increase your orders by cross-promoting. Number four, have a voice. Now, do not just present the data without saying anything or giving any context. That's as good as not presenting. Having a voice means that you have your own point of view. The model makes good predictions. Why is that so? The model predicts poorly. How can we fix that? Be specific when you make a claim. You do not want to be seen as a wishy-washy or indecisive person. Present as you mean it. Do not be afraid to offer a view from a different angle. Your job is to interpret the data and use the analytics results to back you up. Building a data science portfolio is easy and not that expensive. Here are three free services that can help you to get started. Number one, GitHub Pages. Now, if you can write some simple HTML and CSS code, you can create your portfolio using static pages and upload to GitHub Pages. You can use a basic theme or download a clean looking theme from the support site, all for free. If you don't like to code or you prefer to use a what you see is what you get too, using a drag and drop interface, then you may want to try to use a no code platform like Webflow, Wix, or WordPress. Or if you just want to dive straight into writing without worrying too much about the layout and you simply want to focus on the content, you may use medium.com. It's a publishing platform where many data scientists, tech bloggers, and writers use to share their opinions and publish their works. All you have to do is go to medium.com, sign up for an account, and start writing. Here, I'm going to show you two data science portfolios that I quite like it. One is from my students from the Data Science Uncut Bootcamp, and another one is from a senior data scientist. I've put down their links in the description section so that you can take a look at the live version. First of all, let's take a look at the portfolio of Mohan. Mohan's portfolio is hosted on the GitHub Pages, so he used a minimalist template and a straightforward approach. He listed four projects on the main page. Each of the projects that you click on has a summary of what he did and also the problem statement. This is very important. As you can see, he's trying to cater his portfolio to somebody who is looking to hire him. And another plus point is the featured image. So it works like a teaser to hint people to open his link. Once you click on the link to open the notebook in Google Colab, it will bring you to a notebook where you can see the dataset that he used, the step-by-step code, and you can also run this notebook if you want to see the code running live. Another portfolio here is by Hannah Yen. Hannah is currently a senior data scientist in the US because her area is in visualization. So the visual and UI part of her portfolio is obviously stronger. In fact, she came from an engineering background, so her analytic works are equally impressive too. She groups her projects into different categories, and each project that you click will lead you to a blog post. The blog post talks about the background, motivations, and findings, and you can also find the dataset and her code inside the blog post. Having a portfolio is a crucial part of a data scientist career, and you shouldn't update your portfolio only when you are looking for a job or looking to switch your career. If you are a beginner, a portfolio will help you identify your knowledge gaps so that you know your strengths and weaknesses and the areas that you need to level up your skills. Senior data scientists like us, a portfolio will definitely help us to stay updated, make sure that we constantly challenge ourselves and try out different projects in various industries. And it also reminds us to refresh our existing projects with a new technique. Now, do you have a data science portfolio already? If your answer is yes, drop your link in the comments and I'll give you my honest feedback. If not, go ahead and create one now and drop them here. I'll see you in the next video.